If you follow me inside, we can take a look and see what it's like to live on the moon for 7 days. Welcome to the airlock of the lunar lander. Right now you see a lot of foam core boxes surrounding me. These represent the approximate volumes of the spacesuits that the crew members will use on the moon, as well as the different supplies they need to recharge the spacesuits or internal components of the suits. When we actually do our evaluations, we have prototype suits that we bring in, but we don't leave them in here most of the time. We replace them with foam core boxes. The way the module is set up, there is a dome above and below, and we actually can store some things below the floor through the use of this trap door. It looks like a lot of material, but for four crew members to be able to do spacewalks for a week, this is about the volume of equipment you need. And as you see, it's kind of crowded. There's enough room in here for me and maybe one other person. So two people will suit up at a time and go out while the other two remain inside. And let's go through the tunnel to the asset module and we'll see where the other two are and where all four of them live when nobody's outside doing a spacewalk. Represent our spacesuit umbilicals. We can actually attach these to some of the mock-up spacesuits to simulate the astronauts plugging into the vehicle life support system. When engineering builds a second generation of this mock-up, it'll be interesting to see it up on top of the lander deck. I know a lot of people have a hard time conceiving of the height of the lunar lander until they come in here and realize that that's how high the deck is going to be off of the lunar surface.
And of course, this is the TS-3 mock-up.
Right. Looks like the structure of the core hab is done.
Now, what we're doing with this mock-up is we've created the same envelope as the TS-3, which would be a habitable mock-up on the moon. We provided a raised floor so that you can have storage underneath the floor.
Right.
But we've also mocked up where the air tanks and the fuel tanks will be so that you're at the correct height. You can come up the ramp, park, and there'll be a station there where you can leave your suits and things like that. Now, the tourists have, the configuration that we have right now is over in this section, as you see, is kind of looks like a real nice balcony there.
Mm-hmm.
But what that is, it'll be a platform that is able to transition out. Then around the edges is where you'll have your support stations where you can do different types of experiments, or it'll have work surfaces that you can use. And this also is multi-configurable.
Right. So. Yeah, we've been looking at several different possible reconfiguration options. This is pretty close to the original concept that you guys already have.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a major variation that turns this into more of a crew quarters kind of module.
Right.
So it would be nice. The reconfigurability is a great thing. You may be able to mock up one of these configurations, do evaluations, then come back, tear all that out, and do mock up a different, entirely different configuration, and explore different layouts and see how this really works best.